What's the coldest winter you've ever experienced? Now, think colder. Now, what's the most snow you've ever seen? Okay, triple it. You may believe you know all there is to know about the city of lakes, but you're mistaken. Did you know the term holy cow and the most delicious apple ever originated from this city? If one of the most ridiculously over-the-top state fairs or ice-cold polar plunges are at the top of your bucket list, we suggest you buckle up, salt up those tires, and pick up a Caribou coffee, because we're off to Minneapolis. Hey, I'm Jacob, and welcome to Destinations Explained, a fun series we do that dives into destinations from around the world. If you watched before, welcome back. And if you're new here, it's great to have you. If you haven't already, like this video, watch till the end, and down below, write any places we may have missed. Here we go. Minneapolis, the Mini Apple, most commonly known as the Twin Cities with friendly neighbor St. Paul, became a true town after its authorization in 1856. Before then, prior to European contact, the region belonged to the Dakota Sioux, a Native American tribe. The city was formerly known as, this word, meaning the Many Lakes City. After European settlers arrived in the region, things started to take another turn. The events that followed the Revolutionary War in 1783 ensured the US government had a piece of the land, and soon after, they went after and seized full control over the region. It was during this time that Charles Hogue, the city's first schoolmaster, proposed the name Minneapolis, which he coined from combining the native words for waterfall and the Greek word for city. Fast forward to today, where you'll find a city just shy of 500,000 people and a metropolitan area as a whole reaching for almost 3 million people total. In the entertainment world, Minneapolis houses the lovely Guthrie Theater and the First Avenue nightclub. These two buildings are the city's status as the center of funk, folk, and alternative rock music. Minneapolis is home of some of the greatest and most influential celebrities and artists like Bob Dylan, Prince, Lizzo, and Rose Totino, who's of course the co-founder of Totino's Frozen Pizza and a godsend to college students. Weather-wise, it's very mild in the summer, only getting to an average high of around 83 degrees Fahrenheit to a low of 65 degrees Fahrenheit. Not a bad place for a summer trip at all. As for the winters, it's a different story. The cold can be bitter and the snowfall can get out of control. Bring your flannel jackets, hell, bring 10, and layer up, because the high temps can average around 24 degrees Fahrenheit with only an average low of 8 degrees Fahrenheit. How's that for a cold open? Anyway, Minneapolis's history is not why you're here, so let's dive on in and see what's going on in this cold-ass city. Our first stop was previously considered the largest shopping mall in the country because of its enormous size. If you're familiar with football fields or have ever been to one, the Mall of America is bigger than 78 of them. In 2011, Google had to create an indoor map to help customers with navigation. Apart from its many stores, dealing in any and everything you've ever wanted to purchase, the mall also houses a Nickelodeon Universe, an indoor theme park in the center of the mall, featuring roller coasters, a golfing section, and an aquarium with over 4,500 sea creatures. The Mall of America has also been used as a filming location for various films, including, yep, you guessed it, Mall Cops, Jingle All the Way, and others. Nothing in this country symbolizes the United States more than this expansive mecca of concrete, glass, and teenagers. Next up, this Minnesota destination describes itself as the whimsical wonderland of entertaining entertainment, Can-Can Wonderland. Perhaps the best thing about Can-Can is that the company gives back to the artist community with every single thing you do or purchase. This family-friendly establishment boasts mini golf, a full arcade, and all the artisanal pizza your heart could desire. From their great selection of fun games to their wide variety of beer and cocktails that you can actually pour yourself, there's something for everyone to enjoy here. This environment is super immersive for all ages. Looking for a good spot to take a walk or bike through an open area with welcoming air? We know this isn't the nature section of the video, but thanks to this landmark water tower providing panoramic city views, Tower Hill Park makes for a great tourist destination. The park features many things, especially its famous Witch's Hat Water Tower, one of the highest points in the city, said to be capable of holding 150,000 gallons of water, with it being the highest natural spot in the city, and undoubtedly comes with phenomenal views. Too cold to plan this for your visit? Our next spot is a nice and cozy indoor attraction. Is it a golf course? Is it an amusement park? Or is it a restaurant? The answer may not be clear, but we assure you that a visit to Betty Dangerous Country Club will create a memorable experience for you and your friends. MinneapolisNorthwest.com describes Betty Danger as a restaurant and bar pretending to be a country club without the membership fees. The danger, from the name, refers to the attractions at the venue, like a Ferris wheel with open-air dining cars to choose to drink and dine in as you rotate around. They recently rebranded their name to Betty Danger's Animal Farm, but we assure you that they still have their charm. There's also a par 49, 8.5-hole golf course with an 800-pound gorilla. So, if all that information left you with a puzzled look on your face, even after seeing all the visuals, we don't blame you. You'll just have to go and experience it for yourself. What was once an expanse of marshland is now a national award-winning park system that we all know and love. The Minneapolis Sculpture Garden. The garden is home to over 40 outdoor sculptures crafted by artists from different countries. The structure of the garden itself was reimagined and reconstructed by design experts, prolific architects, scientists, and writers. Today's result is a land that supports art, plants, wildlife, and manages stormwater as a resource rather than a waste product. Another interesting aspect is the fact that it's open 6 a.m. to midnight, 365 days a year. So you can visit during the day as a nice relaxing stroll or drop by for the end of a nice romantic night with someone. Next is a place where art, music, fashion, and culture are celebrated, energized, and inspired by the visionary creative spirit of famous singer-songwriter Prince in his home of Paisley Park. The park is known as Prince's home and studio. Prince, while alive, stated that Paisley Park is in your heart. We couldn't agree more. Paisley Park has seen fashion, art, music concerts, tours, and events, and has pulled people from all over the world to witness what happens when art, music, and fashion come together under one roof. Come and enjoy beautiful murals, paintings, and an absolute banger of a wardrobe. And if you haven't noticed, Prince is overall a part of Minnesota culture. He's not just an icon. His appreciation is a way of life here. Before we move on to the nature section, let's have an actual local on to see if they can suggest some good tourist recommendations. Today, we'll be talking to Melissa from @MinneapolisFoodieGirl on Instagram. So, let's see what she has for us.
Hey Melissa, how's it going today?
Good, how are you doing, Jake?
Good, good. So today we are on the tourist section of the video, and I know you're a foodie and you've got all those good suggestions, but I have to know, like, is there any touristy things around the area that we should know about in Minneapolis?
Yeah, there are a ton. I think the one that comes to mind that I'd recommend to anybody interested in coming to the area is visiting Lake Minnetonka. So Lake Minnetonka, it's kind of a funny name, but it's a really well-known lake and definitely the most popular lake around here. It is huge and it is the hot spot for the summer when it comes to spending days out boating, wake surfing, everything that we love to do on the water. There are two cities that I go to most often that are a little more popular. There's Wayzata, which is a really cute downtown area, as well as Excelsior. So those are both cities that are sort of nestled right on the lake, which means you have all kinds of lakeside dining and all types of cute things to do in that area. It is buzzing during the summer. You're gonna see families, couples, singles, kind of a mix of people. And that area, probably Wayzata, is within 30 minutes of downtown Minneapolis. So if you want an Uber, it's actually doable, but definitely if you have a car, it's a very easy trip, not even a full day trip. So if you're in that area and you find yourself hungry, which I'm a foodie, so of course I'm always hungry, but there are, as I mentioned, tons of spots that are kind of peppered along the lake. If you're in downtown Excelsior, I'd really recommend Maynard's. Maynard's is a vibe. It's super fun, tons of energy, a giant deck, docks, boats, all kinds of people having fun during the summer. And then if you find yourself in downtown Wayzata, then I would recommend some good lakeside spots like Cove or Six Smith Steakhouse.
All right, Melissa, well, thanks. That was an awesome suggestion, and I'll talk to you later.
Awesome, thanks, bye.
Don't forget to follow her on Instagram, @MinneapolisFoodieGirl, for some amazing Twin City content. Link in the description down below. All right, let's get into some nature now. Looking for something low-key and close to downtown, just on the other side of the Mississippi, you'll find Boom Island Park, a serene urban park. It's a beautiful open spot right on the water with playgrounds, open fields, and a boat dock. There are spots for picnicking, benches for sitting and relaxing, and the park is more than dog friendly. You'll be accompanied by the Boom Island Lighthouse, which sits on Halls Island a few feet away into the river, which adds to the scenic backdrop of the park. Looking for something more exciting? Let's move on to something more stimulating. Back across the river in downtown Minneapolis, on the west bank of the Mississippi River, lies Mill Ruins Park, which is adjacent to the Stone Arch Bridge. The park is an interpretation, no, a showcase of the years of flour milling in Minneapolis. The Stone Arch Bridge, on the other hand, is a former railroad bridge structure now used as a pedestrian and bicycling bridge. The bridge directly links to the Mill Ruins Park. This is a nice mix of industrial vibes along with the ability to hike, ride your bike, or even running. Running fast food and craft beer down your throat as you sit and admire the Midwest skyline, of course. Minneapolis is popular for its infinite number of lakes. No, really, there is no shortage of lakes here, but this is the lake that makes the list. Or should we say lakes, because it's technically called the Chain of Lakes. Lake of the Isles, Bademakoska, also known as Calhoun, and Lake Harriet. And they're all surrounded by pedestrian paths. Depending on the time of year you go, these lakes will provide a realm of nature and recreation. In the fall, golden leaves will drape the paths and fill your eyes with color. In the winter, the lakes may be frozen and present a winter wonderland. Lake of the Isles Park is a path-lined park that offers various activities such as ice skating, canoeing, and picnicking. It also has an off-leash dog park, so for those of you with dogs that just need to express themselves, feel free to go crazy. Bademakoska is the largest lake in Minneapolis and is popular for its many outdoor activities. But that's not all there is to Bademakoska, let me tell you. The lake is listed by the Minneapolis Park and Recreation website as one of the best in the city for ice fishing walleye, northern pike, and crappies. And if you know anything about Minnesota, you'd know that it's pretty much state law to become a professional ice fisher. And lastly, a beach, a biking path, a beautiful garden, a picnic area, a fishing pier. These are all just some of the features of Lake Harriet. Lake Harriet is considered the gem of the city lakes, primarily because of its beautifully established shoreline. Again, depending on the time of year you visit, you'll either see the lake teeming with people enjoying small sailboats in the summer, or families gliding around gracefully across the frozen surface. So if you only have time for one lake, allude to the information we just threw up at you. But we recommend short trips to all three. Want to experience some real outdoors? How does a waterfall sound? And you don't even have to travel too far. The Minnehaha Regional Park is recognized as one of Minneapolis's oldest and most popular parks. It features a magnificent 53-foot waterfall, as well as river overlooks and limestone bluffs that pull in more than 850,000 visitors annually. We recommend the Minnehaha Falls Loop Trail here. It's less of an intense hike and more fitted for the views of the graceful waterfall. The 193-acre riverfront park also offers alluring gardens, historical sites, a restaurant, and a disc golf course. You could easily spend a day's worth here at Minnehaha Park. Looking for a road trip? Why not visit the next door neighbors over in Wisconsin? Don't sweat it. It's only a half an hour drive to get to Willow River State Park. On the way, you'll get incredible scenery with what seems like a never-ending forest, which really delivers on that away from it all feeling. Once you arrive at the 3,000-acre Riverside Park, prepare to engage in some serious nature. Hope you pack your bathing suit, because you'll be granted with many places to swim and walk into pools and waterfalls. You can also go on a few hikes while you're there, including the Willow Falls and Nelson Farm Trail Loop, or something shorter like the Burkhart Trail. These hikes are nothing most people can handle. As always, helpful links and other information can be found down in the description below. An hour northeast of the city, along the St. Croix River that divides Minnesota from Wisconsin, you'll find an excellent place to have some naturey fun. Interstate State Park. Yeah, not the most creative name, and most people will think you're just stuttering when pronouncing it. But anyway, you can climb the cliffs of the St. Croix River Dalles, watch kayakers, and even stay in camp. We would say this park is best for exploring, bouldering, and just being an all-around adventurous person's paradise. When you're done, stop by the neighboring town of Taylor Falls for a snack and try out the scenic boat tours, where you can take a trip down the river on an authentic paddle-wheeler boat. But wait, there's more. Another neighboring site near Interstate State Park is the Franconia Sculpture Park. Created in 1996, Franconia was founded out of the belief that art can change the world. The park operates a 50-acre outdoor museum housing art from all over the world. For those architecturally inclined and fascinated, this park will fill your mind with fantasy and create an experience unlike any other. So, if you have time to spare, we'd highly recommend making a day trip out of this whole experience. And you know what else we'd highly recommend? Today's sponsor. Look, let's be honest with ourselves. None of us actually follow a healthy skincare routine. And if you say you do, I bet you also tell your dentist you floss twice a day too. Yeah, sure. Keep telling yourself that. But isn't it crazy that we get surprised when a pimple shows up when we don't even give our skin the daily attention it deserves? Luckily for us, Geology made it super easy with their new essential two-step treatment. So what is it? Well, they call it the 1-2 punch of acne treatments. It's a powerful face wash and retinol cream combo that takes 30 seconds, 2 steps, that's it. And you might ask, what makes it different from all the other acne commercials I always see? Well, it's actually healthier because they don't use harsh chemicals like benzoyl peroxide or tretinoin like some of the other people use. But that's not our business. Instead, they use retinol, niacinamide, hyaluronic, and salicylic acid at the perfect ratios for your skin type, which are proven to be the healthiest long-term treatment for your skin. To put it simply, stop burning your damn skin and causing premature wrinkles. Look, Geology's mission is a lifelong skin regimen that is healthy, you can stick with, and that works. No short-term harsh chemicals that do more damage than good. Geology is giving our watchers 50% off, so visit the link in our bio and actually start treating your skin right. And go buy some floss. Just kidding. No one flosses. But you should take care of your skin. You're stuck with it for the rest of your life. Might as well keep it pimple-free. Let's take a detour. You did it. You burned some calories and you deserve some grub. Your friends are sleeping in the back seat of the car with the windows cracked, of course. Or maybe you have a Tesla and you left it in dog mode. Either way, it's time to get some food. Let's start our restaurant list with a fully authentic fish and chipper, dishing up all fresh ingredients with Alaskan cod and hand-cut chips. The Anchor Fish and Chips. A casual eatery offering fresh fish, shepherd's pie, and other classic bar staples. And a ton of Irish beers on tap to get you in the fighting mood. You may think it's just another rundown Krusty Krab just dropping fish and oil like kids at the pool, but we assure you that their plates are so tasty, it's almost fishy. And there's more to choose from, like homestyle burgers, curry, which is perfect for dipping, and poutine, made with gravy infused with poutine, which is essentially Irish moonshine, from Bent Brews Distillery. On the more upscale side of things, we have an amazing Italian restaurant founded by James Beard Award winner Chef Isaac Becker and his wife, Nancy St. Pierre, Bar La Grassa. This eatery is loved for its bruschetta and other small plates to their soft eggs with lobster and orange cauliflower gnocchi. If your mouth isn't watering already from that list of Italian greatness, then wait until you see the wine list, which we actually won't be discussing. What? I'm not a sommelier. It's hunting season year-round at Bar La Grassa, because customers are going crazy for the cavatelli with braised rabbit, as well as their list of other mouth-watering pasta dishes. So whether you're sharing small plates or loading up on carbs, you're guaranteed to get your money's worth here. Next, we have a Polish deli offering Eastern European-style foods for the munching. Seriously, try and find better sausage in the city. We dare you. There's just no competition when it comes to Kramarczyk Sausage Company. Every pierogi and every loaf of bread are handmade completely from scratch, and every ingredient is sourced locally, so you get a full authentic experience when you're eating here. Just listen to Charles from Google Reviews. He wrote, "This is the most hard-hitting authentic experience of my life." Those are some intense words when talking about sausage. Our boy Charlie knows what's up when it comes to European meat. Trust us. How about this gem from Paul? "I like the food. Absolutely breathtaking." In all seriousness, Kramarczyk's is a must try, from a platter of appetizing pierogi dumplings to their famous cabbage rolls. Looking for a greasy spoon? No, we're not talking dirty dishes. For a classic diner experience full of tasty breakfast and lunch options, look no further than Al's Breakfast. It has this beautiful old school look with the perfect location nestled in a nook. Hey, that rhymes. The whole area feels classic. The staff is amazing and the food tastes like home. This is more than a worthy place to spend at least one of your mornings while you're visiting here. We don't care if you're in Minneapolis or in Minnetonka. You just can't say no to poached eggs, waffles, and blueberry walnut pancakes. The cozy atmosphere here reminds me of a place we covered in Nashville, coincidentally named Big Al's Deli. Something about dudes named Al just really know how to run a restaurant. Anyway, shameless plug to our Nashville video, so, you know, go check that out. Our next restaurant recommendation can be found in a section of Nicollet Avenue known as Eat Street, a great area to get a full taste of all the different flavors of the Twin Cities, including Pimento Jamaican Kitchen and Rum Bar. This Black-owned joint specializes in Jamaican street food. The menu packs some serious heat and is quickly served inside this little tropical oasis in the tundra. We think it goes without saying that you need to order the Kingston-style jerk chicken, which comes with coconut rice and beans, sweet fried plantains, and island slaw. Then douse that chicken with some Kingston kick level of heat and don't look back. Tommy Beavis, a co-founder of the establishment, made an impact back in 2020 when protests broke out in Minneapolis last summer following George Floyd's killing. Pimento Jamaican Kitchen was one of the few restaurants on the block that remained open. It became a community hub, feeding the hungry and even distributing necessities like diapers and serving as a gathering spot for activists. So yeah, go show these guys some love. Our next spot was once a food truck not too long ago, and have since moved into their new uptown brick and mortar serving inviting street style grub by the name of World Street Kitchen. They feature a seasonal menu which utilizes only the highest quality ingredients presented in a fun way. The cuisine is inspired by the food served in street carts around the world, from Morocco to Vietnam. World Street Kitchen is the brainchild of two brothers, Iron Chef contestant and semifinalist for the James Beard Foundation Best Chef Award, Sema Wadi, and Saad Wadi, owner of the soon-to-be-mentioned Milk Jam Creamery. If we're talking food, the Yum Yum Rice Bowl may have a funny name, but it packs a serious taste. Pick your meat of choice. We recommend the Korean barbecue beef short ribs, and it'll all come served with steamed rice, a soft cooked egg, peanuts, crunchies, and secret sauce. And you know a restaurant is legit when they got secret sauce. Back in 1954, this Minneapolis landmark opened as a neighborhood burger eatery and has satisfied locals and tourists alike till this day. Matt's Bar and Grill. This isn't just some spot to grab a tasty homestyle burger. This is the home to the Juicy Lucy. Once upon a time, a local customer asked for two hamburger patties with a slice of cheese in the middle. Upon biting into this new molten hot burger, he exclaimed, "That's one Juicy Lucy," and a legend was born. In other words, it's a burger patty stuffed to the brink of explosion with cheese. How much cheese we talking here? Well, the restaurant's motto is fear the cheese, so you be the judge. And as of now, it is a cash-only establishment, so come prepared. Now wait, just because they invented the Juicy Lucy, does that mean they have the best in the city? I mean, Starbucks didn't invent coffee after all. Well, that's not really a good example. Starbucks sucks. Anyway, there's competition these days, and some say that Matt's has nothing on this rivaling joint on the other side of the river, the Nook. This place will put your local burger joint or hop dottie to shame. Bison, turkey, black bean, regular or cheese stuffed, you name it. We guess this cheese stuffed burger is a popular thing here because the Nook does it as well, but takes it to a whole new level. These Juicy Lucy's are apparently award-winning. You ever been to a burger award show? They're crazy. 10/10 would recommend. Oh, you think we're done here? We can't forget to mention the bowling alley in the basement. You heard that right. Grab your lunch and head downstairs to put your greasy little sausage fingers inside of some polyester balls and have yourself a leisurely lunch. All right, before we continue to the last section of our video, let's bring back Melissa one last time to get some food recommendations.
Hey, Melissa, just had to have you back on one more time. It is your time to shine as a foodie. We got to know what are the best spots to eat in the city.
Jake, it's my favorite topic. My go-to is an amazing little spot called Martina. It's nestled in the Linden Hills neighborhood in Minneapolis. It's Argentinian by nature, but also has some Spanish and Italian influences. The chef that opened it, his name's Daniel Del Prado. He is probably the hottest chef in the city right now. Tons of restaurants popping up from him and different concepts, but Martina is his sort of original that we were blessed with here in this city. They just have incredible food across the board, a strong seafood focus. So I personally love the lobster spaghetti, but honestly their burger is to die for and one of the best in the cities as well. So you really can't go wrong. The energy is beautiful, warm, inviting. The cocktails are stunning and complete works of art in and of themselves. And just a great spot for, I would say, brunch or dinner. if you want to go a little more casual than Martina, you can still stay in the Argentinian vein because one of the best pizzas we have here is a place called Boludo. So Boludo is an Argentinian pizza, which is a relatively new concept, at least around here in the last several years, at least for me it was, but it is absolutely spectacular. They have just incredible pizza options, very inventive, very chef-driven, very special, but still casual pizza. And I actually think we do pizza really well here in Minneapolis. My other favorite is a spot called Rectangle. Rectangle came about a couple of years ago. It's based here in Minneapolis, and it really honors traditional Detroit-style pizza, which happens to be my hometown. I'm from Michigan. Detroit is my backyard. And so seeing it sort of pop up on the scene here has been really exciting. They have an incredible style of pizza where it's square shaped and it's got kind of the crusty cheese around the edges and the flavors are through the roof amazing. If you go get the shredder, it's the best one they have in my opinion. And then from there, if you get pizza or you get Martina and you're looking for something to do afterwards and you just want to grab a cocktail at somewhere that has just a great vibe, I recommend the Hewing Hotel. So the Hewing Hotel is in the North Loop area of Minneapolis, and it is stylish and chic and kind of a hot spot, if you will, but it has this nice northern influence vibe to the aesthetic. So it's cozy but classy. Their cocktails are fantastic. They have bites to eat, they have full dinner options, but between their rooftop deck and their main sort of lounge area, it's a place to be seen.
See, this is why I do my calls after lunch, so I'm not sitting here drooling. Those sound amazing. I think everyone's gonna wanna check all those places out. I love the Argentinian culture, kind of out of nowhere, maybe a little unexpected, but it sounds great. So thanks again, Melissa, for joining us, and we'll see you
later.
Thank
you, Jake. Thank you.
Thanks again, Melissa. And remember, a link to her profile is down in the description below. For coffee, we have a local favorite with a handful of locations throughout the metro, 5 Watts Coffee. The East Hennepin branch is an old textile building from 1880, giving the shop a neat industrial feel. Come in the morning and grab a cup of joe while getting some work done, or come in the evening and sip some beer while listening to some live music, or get it to go, because up next, we're gonna go get some ice cream. Now for some dessert, heading back to the Whittier neighborhood, next door to the aforementioned World Street Kitchen, you'll find some of the best ice cream in town at Milk Jam Creamery. Here, you're gonna have a hard time not finding something that makes your taste buds water. They have some wild and funky flavors that are constantly rotating, but here are some of their current ones. Smoked Peach Crisp, Lemonade Stand, Thai Tea, and Vegan Toasted Coconut. There's also floats, shakes, and pints to take home. Hell, you can even stuff a donut with your favorite flavor. And they even do boozy floats for our adult crowd, with a desire to get cavities and a liver disease in one sitting. As always, we'll end our list with a few bars and nightlife gems around the city. This first spot claims that it's the first sake brew pub outside of Japan, and Minneapolis's only craft sake brewery, Motoai. This cozy izakaya features house-made steamed buns, Tokyo straight-style noodles, and rotating seasonal specialties. Not authentic enough? Perhaps the TV streaming sumo wrestling and Japan's public broadcast channel will sell you. On top of that, they have a sumo wrestling fantasy league you can participate in. Now that's a first. With a decent beer list, house-made sake flights, and a rooftop patio, there's no doubt that this place makes for a great night out. Heading over to downtown West, for over 30 years, this pub has been Minneapolis's own little corner of the UK, Britt's Pub. Britt's Pub is famous for its nights by the fireplaces in the winter and lawn bowling on the rooftop deck in the summer. If you don't know what lawn bowling is, it's a lot like bocce ball. And if you don't know what bocce ball is, it's a lot like playing pitch and catch with your dad, who still hasn't come home from the grocery store. This place is spacious, has plenty of libations, and has a must-see veranda. The pub has been named one of the best rooftop bars in the US by multiple publications. That's right, not just Minneapolis or Minnesota, but the country as a whole. Our next bar is more low-key, with an intimate and speakeasy type of vibe, serving classic signature cocktails. Parlor. From beer to wine to liquor, they have it all. And you can't forget their food menu, which includes a killer charcuterie board. The mixed drinks are their most popular, and you bet they're potent, like their famous Old Fashioned. If you're not hungry but still want a snack, then grab a bowl of their popcorn, seasoned with bacon, togarashi, and pineapple. This may be the only place in the world where you can jam out to some hip music, eat popcorn, and wash it all down with a fancy cocktail. Northwest of downtown, you'll find one of the best breweries in the Midwest in the Sheridan neighborhood, Dangerous Man Brewing Company. This brewery is a family-friendly microbrewery and taproom focusing on high-quality, small-batch production beers with ever-changing taps, so you can go in one day and have a whole different experience the next. We think it's safe to say it will get better and better each time. Some of their popular brews includes the Boysenberry Milkshake IPA, Chocolate Milk Stout, and of course their famous Peanut Butter Porter. So if you're a fan of darker, stronger beers, then you'll absolutely love this place. Right next door to Dangerous Man, you'll find Young Johnny, a cozy eatery offering wood fire cooking. But tucked discreetly behind the restaurant is a speakeasy serving craft cocktails down an alley adjacent to Young Johnny. The restaurant was founded by James Beard award-winning chef Ann Kim. The brilliant chef's menu features a diverse array of globally influenced dishes and signature wood fire pizzas like the Korean barbecue pizza, beef short ribs, mozzarella, scallion, arugula, sesame, and soy chili vinaigrette. This is definitely one of the most fancy bar pizzas you'll ever have. There's absolutely so much you can explore in this city. We could have 5 more videos in one category alone, be it restaurants or nature adventures. Minneapolis and Minnesota as a whole just has so much to offer the traveler. Honestly, it's not talked about enough as a must-see destination because it's overshadowed by other overpraised spots that everyone loves to visit. But hey, maybe that's not such a bad thing after all. Maybe we should just keep saying Minneapolis isn't a nice place to be so we can keep all the snow, flannel jackets, and ice fishing to ourselves. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe. And while you're at it, down below, comment which destination we should cover next.